we're actually engaging the business in that process so these systems can get as intelligent as possible and really become, you know, a virtual knowledge worker that's helping your business go forward.
Bill, thanks so much for joining us at our AI Summit interview series called Staying Human. So IBM actually today made a big announcement here at the summit. Can you share some of the details?
Yeah, we did. So today IBM announced trust and transparency for AI in the IBM cloud.
That's huge.
It's coming to the cloud private as well, so it won't be an exclusive to, you know, public cloud thing. We're trying to bring trust and transparency in AI to where your applications and your data resides, to allow clients to deliver AI to their most essential business workloads.
I mean, how's this all going to work?
Yeah,
trust and transparency, it's a big space.
Sounds great, right?
Yeah,
what does that mean? So there's a couple elements to it. And really, you know, the first thing is this is the first step on a journey we have to deliver a number of exciting capabilities to bring enterprises closer to artificial intelligence. And the trust piece is about giving business operations people, giving people who hold the business process sacred, the confidence they need to, you know, frankly, turn the dial from full human to augmented intelligence over time so people can become more productive, have higher throughput, and ultimately generate better customer service outcomes.
So are you starting with the augmentation of your clients in their back shop? Right now, or are you talking all the way up to their customer-facing activities?
We're talking about all the way through. And one of the things we're doing in this offering, this announcement we've made, is we're actually bringing AI directly to the edge, if you will, to the subject matter expert, you know, the actuarial analyst that's doing underwriting for insurance, and not only helping them, but allowing them to have input to the system so it continuously evolves and learns. You know, most artificially intelligent systems today are learning from data scientists, from crowdsourced data labeling systems. We're actually engaging the business in that process so these systems can get as intelligent as possible and really become, you know, a virtual knowledge worker that's helping your business go forward.
Oh, that's fantastic. That's really exciting.
It is.
What else is going on in your space at IBM that, you know, is just getting you super excited on a day-to-day basis?
Yeah, you know, we're working on a number of very exciting things also around helping operationalize AI into these business applications that I've described, delivering, you know, DevOps and lifecycle tooling to really make it easy and seamless to deliver a learning system into a production business application. If you think about artificial intelligence in its most basic form, it's code.
Right.
People have been deploying code into production since the beginning of software. Mm-hmm. So why is artificial intelligence and machine learning such a hot thing in business process and enterprise applications now? I assert that it's because it is a learning system that is continually evolving and giving you different outcomes every day based on how much smarter it got. And that brings a whole new operational paradigm, cultural shifts, mental models and tools required. And we're looking to deliver a whole suite of capabilities that delivers upon that promise as we progress forward in our journey.
Oh, that's fantastic. So you use the word journey. When you're looking at your clients' journeys that you're walking through with them, where do you find that they're hanging up the most or where they're having the biggest struggle or biggest barriers?
Taking machine learning algorithms and models from those who've built them, which, you know, frankly, based on the curriculum that's prevalent in today's colleges, are well-versed in statistical techniques and mathematics, but not necessarily traditional software development lifecycle, IT scale operations, and getting those into the hands of DevOps teams and those who really know what it means to manage software in regulated environments with rigorous change control and stuff.
All of this is very exciting. How big is your team at IBM? How many people do you guys have working on this on a day-to-day basis?
We've got a very large team. And in fact, you know, it goes beyond our development investment. IBM, as you know, is renowned for its research contributions, ranging from quantum computing all the way to the things we're doing in software. And I can tell you that there is an enormous amount of focus and investment from IBM's research teams. Lots of very, very brilliant and smart people coming up with great ideas around how to find bias, detect and mitigate it, as well as deliver on all the promises I just described, in the best way possible.